So I got into diving back in 2004 when I was 9 years old. The diving club from my city, they were doing some talent ID testing. Because I did gymnastics beforehand, I was great at all the tests and went to the pool and really enjoyed what I did there. So that's where I started and I've loved it ever since. Hitting the water and going through the water when you've done a good dive is one of the best feelings. All the work in the air, the execution's gone well, and then you can almost see the water coming. You feel yourself go straight through it, and you can almost hear the sound of the water just tearing as you slide straight through it, which is a feeling that I really enjoy about diving. And that's what I aim to do all the time. I'm very tall for a diver. I stand at about 6'2", 6'3", somewhere around there. I always stand out compared to everyone else, and it's made it quite difficult because I can't spin as fast as some of the smaller divers. But what I do have an advantage in is my strength and weight I can use to push the board down and help me go much higher. So I can make most of the dives that people do, but for the really hard ones, I haven't quite got there yet. In a normal training session, we split our time fairly equally between doing dry land and doing pool. So in the dry land, we have a gymnastics coach now from Ukraine who kind of guides us through more gymnastics-based things, but it's quite related to diving. And we've been doing that since the start of this season, and I've found it very, very helpful. It's made me a better diver, I believe. And then we also do some weight sessions as well. I do two weight sessions a week. We've got like a weights coach in Leeds, and he looks after us, and he's made me much stronger, and that's helped my injuries as well this season, which has been great. Being part of this team has made me the diver that I am today, or helped make me the diver that I am today anyway. Training with guys like Jack Law, Chris Mears, James Denny, Matty Lee, all those boys, they've pushed me to improve every day and dive better. Most of them have been to the Olympics, so I want to join them. Without that kind of motivation, I'm not sure I'd be in the same position.
My favourite thing about training with Yona is that he always brings a positive vibe to the training session.
My favourite thing about training with Yona is that he's always happy and he brings a bit of fun to training.
My favourite thing about training with Yona is that he never ever gives up.
My favourite thing about training with Yona is that I've trained with him for 12 years and he's never changed. He's still a great guy.
The coaches in Leeds are a great pair of coaches. My coach, Edwin, who was the one who spotted me from when I was 9 years old, he's helped me through and helped me understand diving and made me one of the best tall divers around, I guess. The head coach, Adi, he's been working really hard over the years to build the club to how it is now. And I think he's had this vision for a long time, and it's kind of now happening where he's got so many successful divers on the world stage.
I mean, Yona's exciting. He was a bit unorthodox. When we first found him, he was a little bit taller than we'd normally take, because he did come through a talent program. But normally you'd say someone's height in diving like that would be his downfall, but for him he's kind of turned it into his advantage because he's unique. He is the tallest diver in the world. And because of that, he makes his dives look very graceful. And that makes him really stand out in competition, especially when he's diving well. And we've just decided, in order for him to give him his best shot at making it through, just to tailor his list to use some of his slightly easier skills, just so we're more consistent with him. And we've been testing that out recently. It's worked great. He's just been out to America and Canada testing this list out, and it's gone really well. So we're excited. We think he'll pull it off. And if he does get through, then he can throw his hard times back in there.
I wanted to just choose the country that would give me the best opportunities. And after like weighing everything up, as in the size of the sporting program in Jamaica compared to Barbados, I think that was a major factor in the decision, because obviously Jamaica is so strong in athletics and they've got a huge global brand as a sporting nation because of that, and then now they're starting to expand into various other sports. I'm trying to be one of those other sports that they are expanding into that you might not necessarily relate to a Jamaican person. A Jamaican diver is something very, very, very uncommon, and being a part of that is quite cool. I've kind of been on the road to Rio over the last 4 years, which has been an amazing experience. I've been able to go to some amazing countries and see some amazing cities around the world whilst competing.
And there is Yona Knight Wisdom from Leeds.
And it's not always been 100% successful, but it's all been a learning experience, all coming down to this next few weeks where I go to the World Cup in Rio, which is my opportunity to qualify for the Olympic Games later on this year. In the context of maybe a running track, I'd say I'm on like the top bend, which is like the most difficult part of the track, and it's where all my challenges are, which is kind of the competition that I've got to do. When I come through the top bend, hopefully I'll be on the home straight and running towards the finish line being the Olympic Games, and hopefully I'll be doing well still. I just need to hold my nerve together.
Could have history here. Nick Wisdom, here's a chance for a few headlines.
Bring everything that I've learned in the past 4 years, bring that all together for this competition so that I can compete to the best of my ability and do what I know I need to do and do what I know I can do and do what my coaches and friends and family know that I can do, and put six dives together good enough to put me in a position to qualify for the Olympic Games.